I know what you're thinking. New big office, big money, big ideas, very mediocre clothing options. We should hire a bunch of goons, kick back, and just let all the money rush in and wash us. They got $1 million. No. We must stay on it. We must stay focused. We're going to research a new topic first. Yeah, let's go after the hacking market. Look, man, you got to play smart in this industry. You know, you can't just go spending the money all willy-nilly. Make a mature hacking game. It'll be obviously a strategy game for the PC hacking iStorm. Yeah. Advertiser friendly. It'd be so much better as a text-based game. Then again, this is like the age where the GUI became a thing, so I guess we gotta pander to the largest audience possible. Yo, we don't need no dang story in our hacking strategy game. See, here's the thing, man. You gotta play smart here. We could've just hired a whole bunch of goons, but then, you know, we just spent a whole bunch of money on this new gigantic, absolutely unnecessarily large office. You know, we gotta play smart with our money. We don't need no dialogue in our hacking game. The dialogue basically burns down to, hey, I need this terminal hacked. Go and do it. Or in this case, you know, I need iStorm hacked. You know, I need to see my favorite celebrities in their not the most decent of the situations. Maybe good artificial intelligence, like, you know, like there's some like security system. Maybe someone on the other side is like, we're like, hack the Gibson, and like dudes like, get the flu shots and all the other stuff. You know, no one hackers. No, is this? I'm showing my age here. Okay, let's just go. It's kind of sad that in this day and age, referencing hackers could maybe be showing your age. God, the world is just flying by us, folks. Don't need no world design. Graphics don't really matter in your hacking strategy game. Sound, I don't know. Maybe graphics and sound will be on par with each other. You don't really need sound, actually. Maybe graphics. Like a nice, fresh, slick GUI. Something that will never be used in an actual OS because it's too sleek. And, you know, OSs are always behind the times. Boom, get roasted OSs. All right, we didn't gain much from that, but it's okay, you know. That means we stayed with it. We played it safe. But release the game, there we go. We're just gonna go right into our next game. Ain't even finished with the first one. We're gonna make a youngins game. Actually, you know what? We'll make a new time travel game. It'll be a casual time travel game. We'll make it for the game link. Hand time. Yeah. Hand time. You know, every once in a while when you've had a stressful day, maybe a stressful day at school or maybe at work, just want to come home, just grab your device and just do a little hand time, you know, advertiser friendly. Here come the reviews for Hacking iStorm. Oh, dang it. It's going to be one of those. Are we still in normalcy? Oh my God. Should I forget about world design? Are you serious? World design in a hacking simulator game? Excuse me. What, did we have to define what the iStorm people you were hacking were about? Was that the world design that you wanted? All right, it's a casual game, so we should put a lot of focus on story and quests. Gameplay can come down a bit, because this is a casual game, whatever, you know. Engine, solid engine, why not? I feel like the story and the quests are the most important. Now I'm second guessing myself. I thought I knew the hacking simulator crowd, but yeah. Wait, didn't we release bug free? What? I could have swore we released that bug free. Are you kidding me? All right, I guess we got to patch a game. Aren't we in the 80s? Those bugs become quirks for speedrunners, man. That's what it was like back in the day. I mean, how would you even patch an NES cartridge? Stick another cartridge into the cartridge? Like, we're freaking Sega over here? Just stacking things on top, stacking things? How do you patch a cartridge? Excuse me? All right, time travel, we'll put some dialogue in there. Why not? Level design, yeah. Artificial intelligence, almost did not say that right. Not enough intelligence to say artificial intelligence. Okay, after we're done developing our game, we'll develop a patch, all right? Calm your booties. Sound and graphics are probably pretty important for the casual audience. let's just develop the patch. Oh, never mind. Okay, I guess I missed my opportunity to make a patch. Again, you know, I'm just gonna keep that unpatched for the speedrunners out there. You know, I'm thinking about the speedrunners. They can use those bugs to, you know, play my game faster. That's how we roll up in here. Yo, here come the reviews. Oh God. Wow, dude, we are doing bad. Oh my God. All right. Our life of mediocrity continues. All right. Staff management. You know, 100K sounds fine for an advertisement for a small one-person company who really spent way too much money on a damn off. You know, I want a smarty pants on the team. So, complex algorithms. Start looking. Julie Richards. We only found three people with 100K. God dang it. Jeremy Holloway. And Cole Brady. It's between Julie and Cole. I need someone to do my research and whatnot. I mean, Cole would be the better option because he's cheaper, but he's also a little less experienced than Julie. Julie is like cream of the crop, but she's expensive. 18K per month. Actually, you know what? We'll go with Cole. Cole Brady, you are hired. Cole, I want you to research our new topic. It's going to be romance. We're going to go for the Doki Doki audience. We're going to develop a new game. We got to make up, man. We are losing money fast. We lost 200K. 200K with our last two options. We need to bring it back some. All right, let's go into the vault. Let's see what kind of old games we can bring back. Is it too early for a sequel to Ball Handlers or maybe even Pocket Pool? Let's make a sports game. Hardballing. There we go. Yeah. It's like some hardcore ball action. You know what I'm saying? Yeah. Maybe a casual sports game. Sounds like a good match. We're going to go in the game lane. Yeah, we're going to keep it casual. Kind of casual. 2D graphics. Let's go. We don't need no dang stories or quests. Gameplay should be pretty important. Engine, so-so. How's that research going, Cole? Oh, hold on. Let me do this. Dialogue. Oh, AI should be kind of okay. Level design. There we go. Good job, Cole. Can you help me on this game? Or are you just going to sit there? World design, graphics and sound should be pretty high. All right, let's finish this. Hard balling. Ball hard, you know? All right. What is this? What is this meter over here? Come on, hardballing. Dang it. The world hates us. Or the world just tolerates us. We get average scores on everything. Why? Okay, that was pretty good. We're slightly above average games. Oh, okay. Next game. We're going to make a mature game. It's going to be a mature romance game. It's going to be RPG? No. Adventure game? RPG? Adventure game. Romance adventure game. It's going to be for the PC. You know, we're going to keep it simple. Looking for love. 2D graphics. You know what I'm saying? High definition 8-bit jubbles. And ding-dongs. Yeah. The stories and quests should be pretty important for a romance adventure game. Gameplay will bring down a bit. It's all about that story, you know what I'm saying? Dialogue, very important in a romance adventure game. Level design, yeah, we'll keep it up there, you know? Make some nice locales. Don't need much artificial intelligence in there. You're not coded to think, you're coded to follow a script. Good graphics, sound can come down a bit. World design, pretty important, I think, in an adventure game. There we go. I think we got this one in the bag. Triple A, 5-star ratings all across the board. Oh, so many balls. Oh. Double the balls, double the fun. Oh, speaking of balls, hardballing off the market. Okay. Yeah, new record. Now we're hitting new strides, leveling up. Yeah. There we go. Release that bad boy. All right, come on, baby. Oh no, this could go either way. An 8, all right, good start. Come on, all right. Yeah. All right, nice. They like the romance. Think we found a sweet spot there. 8787. Man, we did romance pretty well. That was our first romance game, folks.